What would a traditional holiday concert at Hoffman Estates High School be if it didn't start with sleigh ride? We are so glad that you are here and a part of this annual tradition for us 41 years ago. This concert began. It was called Hoffman's Gift to the Community, wherein the band, the orchestra, and the choir combined to present a community gift. And it is just wonderful that we get this opportunity to continue that. Sleigh ride, of course, we all know from walking through the mall and listening to a variety of concerts, written in 1946, actually in July of 1946. There wasn't a lot of snow in Boston at that time for Leroy Anderson, who wrote it for the Boston Pops Orchestra, that then played it at one of their holiday concerts, and it's been a staple of their programs ever since. Music of this millennium is next for us, The Polar Express. Many of us knew the book long before the movie and all the great roles that Tom Hanks played. You will hear many of the songs with which you are familiar if you have had the privilege of seeing that movie. And its basic theme is Believe. And we invite you to reminisce about this particular holiday season, as it is particularly special for you in whatever way you might celebrate it, but always remembering the Believe aspect of the Polar Express. At the very end of this piece, you will hear the chimes ring forth, and all we will ask is that you allow the chime sound to completely decay before you might offer applause. The Polar Express. one of the aspects of our program that has been really, really wonderful over the years has been a tradition for school board members to attend our holiday programs. And that there hasn't been anyone in the time that I've had the privilege of being here that has been more loyal or interested in coming to our concerts than Mrs. Anna Klimkowitz. And I know that Anna is here tonight. Anna, if you would be kind enough to just keep us in the room. Our programs, not yet, Mrs. Ordonez. Also, a couple of others that I do not want to miss being able to acknowledge. We are blessed with a wonderful staff here at Hoffman Estates High School. On our staff within the band program is Mr. David Orlitz and Mr. Chuck Reese. Mr. Reese is our percussion teacher. And we are blessed with the support of our principal here at Hoffman, who has even brought a couple of his children here tonight, and we are thrilled that he has done that. Mr. Josh Shoemaker is our principal this year. And he's our closing piece is involving the choir as well as the band. Another of the things that I think is very special about Hoffman in the way of traditions is that our students participate in more than just one music ensemble. And you saw a number of students walk off the stage, not because they all suddenly had a case of indigestion, but because they were going to join our choir. The piece, White Christmas, was written in 1940, but was not performed publicly until 1941, Christmas Day of 1941, 2.5 weeks after Pearl Harbor. Bing Crosby sang it on his radio program called the Kraft Music Hall, and it was a huge hit. And as we all know, there are lots and lots of renditions. Mr. Crosby's recording was a part of the Polar Express, and he has sold himself, or his, now it goes to his estate, of course, but there are over 100 million copies of that song sold just of his recording. There are over 500 recordings around the world by various artists of White Christmas. So we hope that as in this season, as it brings back some of the memories of this holiday season, and all of us don't necessarily celebrate Christmas. There are a number of other holidays involved in this time of year. But the point is that it's about family, it's about home, which was very important to the soldiers in World War II and very important to their families. There was a sense of togetherness, even though they were separated by an ocean on either side of our continent. So we hope you enjoy this particular arrangement of Irving Berlin's White Christmas.
Thank you. Hoffman Estates High School Madrigal Singers, and they just came off of their Madrigal dinner this weekend. I would say it was quite successful. We even had our before that our first opportunity to be on TV on the WGN Afternoon News. So we've had a really busy and exciting month this month. So they're going to do a version of We Wish You a Merry Christmas that we normally do a cappella, but kind of as a way to change it up, and also as a special treat for you, we're going to do it accompanied, and our accompanist for the first time here is going to be Mr. David Richards on the piano, way over there. So would you...
Recent commissions have included choral works, instrumental pieces, art songs, film scores, and musical theater. Eric is a doctoral student in music composition at the University of Maryland under Dr. Mark Wilson. He also holds an MM in composition from the University of North Carolina, Greensboro.
Nuova Ecija by Emil Desamores is a retelling of the story of Jesus' birth, but with a distinct twist that is completely Haitian. The sonic atmosphere of Noel is characterized by singers' imitations of traditional Haitian folk instruments. For centuries, music has been an invaluable part in Haiti's cultural identity. The instruments are included in this nativity story as musical offerings to the newborn child. In this case, these are the maracas, the vaccin, the manibula, and the banjo. Desamore's delightful lyrics proclaim, back then, if we'd been there, we'd have done something fitting, and we'd have offered him the best kind of Haitian music.
We kind of realized what we were doing, and we're all taking a different approach to them and a different tack to them. For ours, there's a newspaper article that I've always found very interesting. It was actually from the late 1800s, 1894, I think. And it was back in the time when, you know, kind of communication happened in a different way. And a somebody wrote into the newspaper and actually got an answer. So we're going to give you that newspaper article as part of our version of the book.
Dear editor, I am 8 years old. Some of my little friends say there is no Santa Claus. Papa says, if you see it in the sun, it's so. Please tell me the truth. Is there a Santa Claus? Virginia O'Hanlon.
Virginia, your little friends are wrong. They've been affected by the skepticism of a skeptical age. They do not believe, except they see. They think that nothing can be which is not comprehensible in by their little minds. Yes, Virginia, there is a Santa Claus. He exists as certainly as love and generosity and devotion exist. Alas, how dreary would be the world if there were no Santa Claus. It would be as dreary as if there were no Virginians. There would be no childlike faith then. no poetry, no romance to make tolerable this existence. Not believe in Santa Claus. Nobody sees Santa Claus, but that is no sign that there is no Santa Claus. The most real things in the world are those that neither children nor men can see. You may tear apart the baby's rattle and see what makes the noise inside, but there is a veil covering the unseen world which not the strongest man could tear apart. Only faith, fancy, poetry, love, romance can push aside that curtain and view and picture the supernatural beauty and glory beyond. Is it all real? Ah, Virginia, in all this world there is nothing else as real and abiding. No Santa Claus. Thank God he lives, and he lives forever. 1,000 years from now, Virginia, nay, 10 times 10,000 years from now, he will continue to make glad the heart of childhood.
Softly falling. Thank you. Hallelujah, hallelujah.